Of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, Pax Christi.
Evening, Father.
Pax Christi encompasses a lot tonight. Most of all, we have the confirmation retreat at Mass with us tonight. The confirmation candidates from here at Pax Christi, and also the confirmation candidates from Christ the King. Let's see, where would they be sitting in church tonight? Let's bless them and welcome them into our celebration. Some wise people have joined us for our Saturday night Mass, not knowing what the morrow may bring. And, of course, we know that Omicron continues to rage. We try to be as careful as we can here at Pax Christi. Let's take care of each other. In particular, in the communion lines, we don't have to bunch right up on each other. We can continue to just leave a little bit of distance even as we come up for communion. So, taking care of each other and knowing most of all that God's with us and that God's care is over us all, let's ask for the Lord's guidance and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are a mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and the splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let's pray together. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her vindication shines forth like the dawn, and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication, and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken, or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight and your land espoused. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name.
Marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among the peoples, his wondrous deeds.
Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Give to the Lord, you families of nations. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory due his name.
Marvelous deeds to all the nations.
Worship the Lord in holy attire. Tremble before him, all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is king. He governs the peoples with equity.
Marvelous deeds to all the nations.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, there are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. To one is given through the Spirit the expression of wisdom, to another, the expression of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another, faith by the same Spirit, to another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another, mighty deeds, to another, prophecy, to another, discernment of spirits, to another, varieties of tongues, to another, interpretation of tongues. But one and the same Spirit produces all of these, distributing them individually to each person as he wishes. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran short, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were six stone jars there. There were six stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washing, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine, without knowing where it came from, although the servants who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and then when the people have drunk freely, an inferior one. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this as a beginning of his signs at Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Tonight I have a prelude and then hopefully a brief homily and then a really long homily. No, I'll try to keep the second homily brief as well. First, in my introduction this morning, or this evening, I forgot to include all of you who are Pax Christi at home. Again, we know that you are a part of our Mass today. We know your prayers are with us and that our prayers are with you. When I think about confirmation, I think of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and in particular, the seven traditional gifts of the Holy Spirit that come from chapter 6 of Isaiah, when Isaiah speaks about God giving a spirit on a king, a leader, wisdom and knowledge, courage and fortitude, fear of the Lord. And so I'm always praying that our confirmation candidates are seeing the gifts that they have from God, the gifts that God is offering. And so tonight, my gosh, what I heard, a wisdom, gift of wisdom. There are people, there are our candidates tonight who are going to, and you, candidates, you're going to have a gift of wisdom. Some of you have the gift of healing. Some of you in your life will be healers, not just in medicine as a nurse or doctor or therapist, but healing wounds in people's spirits. You can be healers of relationship. And some of you are going to do mighty deeds. You're going to do mighty deeds in your career. You're going to do mighty deeds through your church that are going to be a blessing to many people. The people who are leading you through your retreat today. They're doing mighty deeds with their life, in their church, and in their relationships. And you're going to have those gifts too. When is Christ the King's confirmation? Nice and loud for me. Oh my goodness, yours is much nearer. So what's the gift? What's the gift you're praying for? When the bishop anoints you with oil in the Holy Spirit, what will you be praying for? Pax Christi's confirmation is in May. You have a little bit more time to figure it out. What is your gift, and what are you going to ask for? Because the gift of the Spirit when the bishop comes is a mighty thing itself. Now we look at our gospel. And on its surface, it's clearly a miracle story. And on its surface, it's a story of generous kindness and done kind of anonymously. And because it happens at a wedding reception, it made me think this past week of married couples whom I know and admire, and I won't go into all the stories. People of generosity, people who have really dedicated their lives to service. The deacon couples that welcomed me when I went to St. Mildred in Somerset decades ago. Wonderful couples. I get in trouble when I name names, but it's St. William in London. Chad and Carol Jackson are among many wonderful couples. A few of you will know Chad and Carol. You know what I'm talking about. Different people, different gifts. And what I thought about this week is, as good and admirable as each one is to know, they are better together. It really is true, isn't it? As much as we admire this particular person or that one, they're better together. Each individual is better because they're together. There's a wonderful mystery there. There is a wonderful mystery of how God's grace works. We can look around the room and we can see many examples of that. Of good, generous people, people who do mighty deeds, people who are helpers, and whom I admire individually, but then I know that you're better as a couple, even when you don't always get along. You're better together. And, so, we admire these individuals. We have great admiration for each other here. But we know something deeper is going on in the way that couples are better together. And there's certainly much more going on in our gospel tonight. Jesus' kind of offhanded way of saying, "My hour is not yet come." She knows he's going to do it. Do whatever he tells you. That's the way my mom would say it. Do whatever he tells you. He's going to do it. Don't worry. And John's gospel just says, this is the first of the signs. And so this is a story about a generous kindness, but it's way more than that. It's a story about God's love at work in each of our lives. In the sacrament of baptism, in the sacrament of Eucharist, in the sacrament of marriage, and even in this sacrament of confirmation, a little harder to fit confirmation into our gospel than it is to our second reading, But in the sacrament of confirmation, God at work in our lives, being present to us in our lives. And just as it's so neat, just as it's so inspiring when we see, you know, couples in their unity being so powerful and mighty, so also let's make sure that we see that mystery at work in each of our own lives with Jesus. We're better because of Jesus. We're better because we've been baptized. We're better because he dies and rises and gives himself to us in this Eucharist. It's a mystery how it happens. I mean, I love these people. It's a mystery sometimes how it happens among married couples. Sometimes it's a mystery how it happens in each of our own lives. But tonight we get to look around with such admiration and pride. But we also get to say, to look into our hearts and say, yep, Jesus, you're doing a mighty work in my life too. I'm better because you have given yourself to me and to each of us in such generous and kind ways. Let's make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. And he rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. And I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now, let's offer our prayers. Let's offer our prayers for the Lord to bless all the earth in his holiness.
That the church is action of peace and love demonstrates to nations of the world how they should act towards one another. We pray to the Lord. For world leaders, that they try to fulfill Martin Luther King's dream of peace, we pray to the Lord. As we celebrate Martin Luther King Jr.'s Day, may God give us strength of body, mind, and spirit to keep walking for freedom, to remain nonviolent, even though we may face death. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
That lawmakers and healthcare workers work to protect the sanctity of life from conception to natural death, we pray to the Lord. that men, women, and children obey God, just as Jesus obeyed Mary at the wedding at Cana. We pray to the Lord. For all those in our parish who need prayer, and all those who are being made perfect through suffering, that they share the cross of Jesus and may also be anointed with his joy and grace. We pray especially for the eternal joy of John Jack Saltburn. We pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, you give us your Son in the Eucharist. Strengthen us through this sacrament to do your will on earth. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, sisters, brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Tonight, I am using the preface for the Mass for weddings. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ. For in him you have made a new covenant with your people, so that as you have redeemed man and woman by the mystery of Christ's death and resurrection, so in Christ you might make them partakers of divine nature and joint heirs with him of heavenly glory. In the union of husband and wife, you give a sign of Christ's loving gift of grace, so that we might all draw, so that the sacrament we celebrate might draw us back more deeply into the wondrous design of your love. So with the angels and all the saints, we praise you, and without end, we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop. Remember, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who've pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We pray for the blessings of the kingdom, and we offer our lives in faithful service. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
Peace, my dears. Peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
One important announcement that I will ask you to pay good attention to. We would like to begin taking communion to the homebound. And we have many people who are interested in doing it. We started by once again taking communion to the Catholics in the local nursing homes. But now we also are reaching out to people who are staying in their own homes for health reasons. We need everyone here to help us remember and identify who the people are in our parish, who are, you know, in the traditional sense of the term, homebound for health reasons. If you know someone, do not hesitate to let us know. Now, let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread one in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.